right. Well, we are making another connection. It's a segment I've started calling Quarantine Calling, where I tell you how this came about. I stumbled upon this Facebook group called A View From My Window, and I've noticed these amazing photos that people are posting from all over the world of, as the name says, the view from outside their window as we're all stuck inside dealing with this coronavirus that has put the entire planet on lockdown. So joining me now from Vasa, Finland, Hanna Turpinen. Am I pronouncing that correctly?
Yes, Hanna Turpinen. Yeah, you pronounce it really well.
Oh, well, thank you. And it's a pleasure to meet you. You posted a gorgeous photo of a very snowy backyard. How's the weather in Finland today?
Well, right now, I'm sitting in my glass porch, so it's still sunny. It's about 10 degrees Celsius, so it's not too bad, but it could be warmer. But that day, we were already looking at springtime and tulips and other flowers blooming, and all of a sudden there was another snowstorm, so that sort of caught us by surprise.
There are some states here in the U.S. that are also having horrible winter storms now, and it's April 16th today.
I noticed in the group that you were mentioning, the wonderful view from my window group, so so I noticed that there's a lot of snow in some northern parts.
Oh, yes.
Of the U.S. as well.
I happen to be in South Florida, so we're having a heat wave down here. It's been in the 90s, actually, Fahrenheit. It's quite warm. So at least we have that going for us. So if we're stuck, at least we can go out in the backyard and get some sun. How did this unfold in Finland, the whole staying at home? When did you guys get alerted that there was this pandemic brewing and that things were going to change?
Wow, when was that? Was sometime in February. It's actually, I find it kind of hard to keep track of time. I can't even, is it fourth or fifth week that I'm working from home now? I'm not even sure. But it was sometime at the end of February. First, it was still called an epidemic somewhere in northern Italy, parts of Switzerland, then suddenly Spain, Germany, and then it reached us as well. It's not all that bad yet, but the peak of the epidemic, we haven't reached that yet, I think.
Uh-huh.
They're about, Finland is quite scarcely populated, so there's a lot of space, so I think things are not evolving that fast here. So there are about, 3,000 and a half cases right now. But we're still expecting the peak of the epidemic.
Yeah, it's scary. So is there an order to shelter at home, or is this voluntary? What's the mandate there?
Well, a bit of the both. We're not in a lockdown. We're not in a current quarantine state. We can move about freely outside, but gatherings above 10 people are prohibited.
Mm-hmm.
The schools are closed. The university, I work at the University of Vasa, so we're closed. We can't even enter the buildings without permission, so we're working from home. So we're basically... A lot of people are working from home, but the shops are still open.
Oh, really?
We can go out. We can go out to exercise. The restaurants are closed. Mm. They can only sell food as takeout menus. And
how is the medical care system in Finland?
In Finland.
Are you taken care of? It's a universal health care provided by the government, paid for by your taxes?
Yes, it's actually, it's excellent. We do pay a lot of taxes, but our social security system is really good. So we pay something if we end up in a hospital, but that's only like a really small fraction of the actual costs. And they're trying to flatten the curve so that... Mm-hmm. In case there's a huge epidemic here, there'd be enough places in intensive care. units. And as it seems right now, that's what they're managing to do. So people that end up in the hospitals are in moderate. I think some 200 or 300 have ended up in hospitals.
No. That's not bad. With a much smaller population over there than here, certainly, but it sounds like they've got a handle on it and people are at least observing the social distancing and trying to keep it from spreading.
And
right?
That's something really characteristic of my nation, I think. We're really known to keeping our personal space so that it's easy to follow the orders to not go too close to other people.
Uh-huh. Now, you said you work at the university. What do you do there?
Yeah. I work at the HR and I work with international HR. So I help new foreign or international researchers when they settle in and move to Finland. And when our researchers are going out for research exchanges to other countries. So this affects my job quite a lot, actually.
Oh, sure. I bet. Well, obviously the university is closed. All schools are here are closed as well. Kids are, parents are having to do homeschooling and work with e-learning programs. So it's a whole new world. Thankfully, my daughter is out of school, so I don't have to deal with that.
Yeah.
But we're navigating different things. So at university, same thing there is public is higher education also included in your taxes? So when a child finishes high school, they get to go to university and that's also paid for?
Yes, it's free for all. So there are entrance exams, but those who get in get a free schooling.
Wow. And you hear the incredulity in my voice because I'm sure you sound like you know what's going on and you know what the system is like over here in the U.S.
It's I do.
Insane.
Yeah. So I have a 10-year-old son, so I don't have to worry about getting him to school or start saving for his university education. That sort of included in my monthly taxes that I pay.
Wow. So. Yeah. Here, there's a lot. So many people are now unemployed because with businesses shutting down, people, as of today,
here,
5.5 million more people filed for unemployment benefits in this past week, bringing it to 22 million people in just 4 weeks. So the unemployment is crazy. And unfortunately, in this nation, it's so nuts that your health care in many cases is tied to your employment. It's provided. Insurance is provided by the employer. So all these people who are newly unemployed now find themselves without health insurance. And people are really scared because if they do get sick and go to the hospital, they're going to wind up with a huge bill that could bankrupt them, that could destroy their lives going forward. It's really insane.
It's heartbreaking. It's really breaks my heart even to think about that. Another worry besides this virus itself.
Right. To have to think about paying for it. I'm wondering how, obviously here in the States, we think everything revolves around us. I'm wondering what kind of coverage there is of how we're handling it over here. We have, I don't know your views of him. My view of the guy in the White House right now is that he's an insane madman who is not only destroying this nation, but he's doing his damnedest to destroy the planet. We are in desperate straits over here with this guy in the White House and just hoping we make it to November so we can vote him out of office. I'm wondering what the coverage is like over there in Finland of him. Did the rest of the world see him as insane as most of us do?
Well, he gets a lot of highlights in the news.
Yeah, a lot of coverage, right?
Because, yes, coverage. The decisions are quite abrupt, like the decision to shut down the financing for the
WHO. Unbelievable.
I
feel like when I make these calls to talk to people around the world, like I have to apologize for him to the rest of the world. I am so sorry that a faction of the people in this country voted this idiot into office. I'm mortified by him. And we're all just like holding our breath, hoping we make it through to November and can get him out of office, because it's not only embarrassing, but cutting off funding to the World Health Organization in the middle of a global pandemic, it's unconscionable. And so, again, I, on behalf of my fellow Americans, I apologize.
Politics. What can you do? Yeah.
What's the government like over in Finland?
In Finland, right now, we have a kind of new government. Our prime minister is youngest female prime minister in the world.
Oh, really? So I thought that was New Zealand. That's Finland, huh?
she just started her term not too long ago, and boy, what a start of the term for her. But
good or bad?
They're doing a great job, though. Tough decisions, but I'm really proud of her and her government. They're doing a good job.
Oh, that's great. So glad to hear it. And I think, look, we've got some young people in Congress that I'm hoping will work their way up, because it's time for a change in leadership. I'm also kind of upset about the choices we have to replace Donald Trump in November. We're down to Joe Biden, who was not my number one choice, but he'd be night and day better than Donald Trump. As I say all the time, my dog Jackson would do a better job as president than Donald Trump. So hopefully we'll be able to apologize to the rest of the world in a better way, at least come November, if we survive that long. I'm glad to hear that you've got a new young look. This is a trend, I guess, young women taking over, because the prime minister of New Zealand is also a young woman who's getting rave reviews for her work as well. So maybe this is a welcome new trend we're seeing.
I must say that they are doing a great job now. So all my best wishes and luck go to our new government.
Absolutely. Hannah Terpanian, it is so great to connect with you. That we're all in the same situation, no matter where we are on the planet. There's something kind of comforting
amazing.
About
and,
that, right? And I
and
just
somehow the group, the view of my window, makes it so real.
Yeah.
To see. Yeah. We're all struggling with the same thing now.
We are. And I don't think we've ever had a moment like this in world history before, where we were all going through a similar crisis together. And that's why I want to connect with people. I'm so glad you took a few minutes to talk with us today. It's a pleasure to meet you. I'd love to
it's
one
a pleasure
day in person.
To meet you too.
Thank you so much, and stay warm there in Finland. And
we will now. Summer is coming up, so it's going to get sunnier and it's going to get warmer.
Awesome.
So that's one positive thing.
It is. It's after 7 p.m. there now, and I see it's still light outside. How late does it stay light?
Right now, maybe until 9 o'clock in the evening. But, you know, we're looking at a period when the sun will never set. So when it's midsummer here, it's going to the sun is going to shine all night through. So
that's why
we'll need our thick black curtains again to be able to sleep.
And how warm does it get when the sun is out 24 hours a day?
The summers are really nice, about 20, 25 degrees, I'd say.
Celsius. Yeah.
For us, it's sort of a perfect temperature.
I hear you. All right. Well, I'm spoiled. You know, I live in South Florida, so I don't deal with snow or any of that.
I do envy your heat wave right now, I must say.
Well, I'll send a little heat your way.
Thank you.
Virtually, anyway.
Stay safe.
And you too. And it's a pleasure meeting you and talking to you. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you.